have a lot of the VCU family here, and certainly some folks who, it's been a while since they've been back on campus, but we're so proud to have them back. And today's going to be a lot of fun because we're going to get to relive so many of the greatest moments in VCU sport history that were produced by the folks that we're honoring here today. First up, please allow me to welcome and introduce the Director of Athletics for VCU, Ed McLaughlin.
Thank you, Greg, and welcome. Welcome back to those who are alums and haven't been to campus for a while. Welcome to those who have never been to campus. I'm sure for the alums who haven't been back for a while, it probably feels like you've never been to this campus, how much it's changed over the time. But, you know, I always say VCU is one of the most dynamic places in the country, and an incredible campus. We are able to be dynamic. We are able to have this incredible trajectory that we've had as a department and as a university because of what the people in this room did, because of the alums here, the people going to the Hall of Fame who laid a foundation for us that made everything that we knew possible. And we do things at an incredibly high level right now. It's amazing. It really is. But we would not be able to be here if it weren't for all of your accomplishments. Kristine, Martina, Boris, Deli, Jen, I mean, the things that you did here, as I was reading over your stats, it was incredible. I mean, you know, and it's not just the things you did here as players, which were incredible, but what you meant to this community is amazing. Some of the stats are almost really unbelievable in the level of accomplishment, what you did. And you are certainly an inspiration to all of the student athletes we have now. We have a saying around the department, if you do everything at a high level, if you are high level athletically, if you are high level academically, if you are high level socially, if you are high level behaviorally, if you work hard in the weight room, if you take care of all the little details, you will do all those things at a high level, the winning takes care of itself. And I really do believe that. And our student athletes have bought into that. But you are all great examples of people who did things at a high level in every way, shape, and form. So welcome back. It's nice to have all you back. It should be a fun day. I'll keep this part moving, and we're looking forward to hearing your stories. And I'm glad we have some of our current student athletes here in the room to hear some of the stories that you'll tell. Hopefully, they will be all PG stories, which would be great if you could keep it that way today. That'd be awesome because we do have children in the room. But you know what? The reality is, it's just fun hearing the stories of back in the day. And I usually hear from Coach Costin. He tells me all the stories. And you never know if Coach is kind of stretching the truth a little bit or not, but certainly we'll be able to validate some of those today. But thank you for being here. Enjoy the day, and on behalf of VCU Athletics, thanks for all you've done to make this place great. Take care.
We're going to get our program started today. The folks here from VCU Athletics have prepared a special video presentation for each inductee that'll play before their formal induction. So that's where we'll begin. I'd like to bring up Athletic Director Ed McLaughlin, who's going to participate in the formal inductions, and of course to introduce our first honoree today, VCU Women's Basketball Coach Beth O'Boyle.
I'm probably the shortest person in here. Sorry about that. Got to move that. Good afternoon. I'm Bethel Boyle, the current women's basketball coach here at VCU, and it is with great honor and pleasure that I introduce Kristine Austgulen to the VCU Athletics Hall of Fame.
Thank you.
Oh, we're going to take a picture.
As the Associate Vice President and Director of Athletics at Virginia Commonwealth University, I am proud to induct you and welcome you into the VCU Athletics Hall of Fame.
I think we get better in style with age, no? hair is just, wow. Okay, yes. This is the first time I'm back here in 14 years, which is crazy for me. And when I got on the plane, it just kind of hit me, and I had a moment. I thought about the whole journey to actually get here from Norway, which is a story in itself. I was just telling the people over here. I thought about the time when I was here, when I just can think of every emotion in the book, blood, sweat, tears, everything else. And then I thought about how much it really has impacted me in terms of lessons about teamwork, discipline, and everything else. Should I tell funny stories or should I be serious? Well, I'm going to be serious. There are a lot of moments I could talk about, but I would just like to say, express my gratitude. First of all, to my parents, that I think the reason I'm standing here is them. Basically made me think that I could achieve anything I want to. My only obligation is to fulfill my potential. That's it. My brothers. And my coaches and my teammates in Norway, especially the one coach who asked me in 96 after a practice whether I ever thought about playing college basketball. And he said, I think you might be good enough to play Division I. So that pretty much changed everything for me. I want to thank the two coaches that are sitting here right now, Coach Radford and Coach Glass, who basically just recruited me by chance. They wanted to get another player, but just happened to see me on the same team. So, pretty luck. And they always gave me that chance and believed in me and helped me build character for the 4 years that I was here. So I'm really thankful for that. Also want to thank all my teammates. I want to thank the athletic administration, the staff, the trainers, and everyone that was here. I think I might be the first Norwegian basketball player to be a Division I in the Hall of Fame, which is kind of cool. So, thank you so much for this honor. I'm very proud to be part of the VCU family. Thank you.
Nedelkova piled up 44 goals and 101 points in four seasons in a VCU uniform from 2000 to 2003. His 39 points in 2003 ranked third in school single season history. He scored 15 goals that year and led the Rams to an NCAA tournament second round victory over Virginia Tech. He lifted VCU to CAA championships in 2002 and 2003 and was named tournament MVP on both occasions. Nedelkova was named Virginia State and CAA Player of the Year in 2003, as well as First Team All-South Atlantic Region and Second Team All-America by the NSCAA and College Soccer News. Since graduating from VCU, Nedelkova has enjoyed a long, successful professional soccer career, most notably with USL's Richmond Kickers, where he's become the leading scorer in club history.
To introduce our next inductee, please welcome VCU men's soccer coach Dave Gifford.
Thank you, Greg. I'd like to introduce Matthew Delacott.
Matthew, as Associate Vice President and Director of Athletics at Virginia Commonwealth University, I am proud to induct you and welcome you into the VCU Athletics Hall of Fame.
As you can see from the video, my hair choices haven't improved much over the years, but you know, I'm a little bit different to Kristine. I moved over here 17 years ago, and I've been here ever since. I've made it my home. I've lived in Richmond for 14 out of the 17 years. I'll tell you a couple of stories. The first one is how I ended up here, and Ted Jones is here today. He came from a similar part of Wales where I was playing soccer about 18 years ago, and I had been playing soccer, looking to try and pick up maybe a professional team right out of high school, and Ted called me up and told me about the opportunity to come play here in Virginia, and I had never heard of VCU, never heard of NCAA, any of that stuff, and within about 3 or 4 months I packed 2 suitcases and moved out here and was playing for VCU soccer. And you know, next thing you know, 17 years have gone by, and here I am standing here today. So it's definitely been, you know, a whirlwind of a life for me since I've come out here. On another note, I just played my 13th professional season, and I'll actually be announcing my retirement from the game on Monday. So, you know, my dad's here from Wales, and he's not very happy with the decision. He wants me to keep playing, but I'm kind of at the point where I'm ready to move on and go into the next chapter of my life. So, you know, I have a lot of exciting things I'm doing with a new business, and I'm looking forward to that. Obviously, playing my final season, I was hoping to kind of go out on top and, you know, be the top scorer and win a championship, and it was kind of a strange year for me, because right as I was getting fit and getting back in the team, I had an injury in practice and fractured my back, and subsequently found out that there was a mass on my kidney, and they told me I had kidney cancer, had a partial nephrectomy, had the mass removed, you know, I was going to be out for indefinitely until that healed. Week after the surgery, the doctor said the mass came back benign, so it wasn't cancer after all. So, you know, all my teammates now were making fun of me for faking cancer and just to get some attention. So, you know, it wasn't quite the season I envisioned. And then we got knocked out in the first round of the playoffs after getting a red card probably 3 minutes into the game. So it wasn't the picturesque final season I wanted, but, you know, the fact that I even stepped on the field again that season was a really good feeling, and I can look back on my career and be proud for sure. And like I said, my dad's been my biggest fan over the years, and he's always encouraged me. You know, ever since I was this high, he never told me, you know. Go and do the school thing and forget about soccer. He always just told me to follow my dreams. And, you know, even though I've been playing in the USL, which isn't necessarily a glamorous league, I've been doing what I love. So that's, you know, really good. The one problem with my dad coming over and watching me play, though, is every time he came, we either lost or I got injured. So I got to the point where I had to try and get him on the no-fly list so we could try and win. And then finally, we did win a championship with the Kickers in 2009, and Dad was watching from back in Wales. So, and then lastly, you know, I'd like to thank my fiance for taking care of me. She's an RN, and you know, helped me through my surgery and was there for me. She did say I was the worst patient she's ever had in her life, but I know you know, she'd do anything for me, and I appreciate that. And we have six kids between us, so I've got three and she has three, so we have our own little Brady bunch, and it's you know, I feel very fortunate to be in such a great place with so many great people here. So I just make sure I think I got everything on my list that I needed to say. Obviously, I was going to address the man bun. After being laid up after the surgery, I just kind of let my hair keep growing, and I just decided I'm going to keep growing it until I can donate it to Locks of Love. So, you know, my stepchild says I look like a female UFC fighter, which is kind of embarrassing. But as embarrassing it is, you know, I'm doing it for a good cause, so I'm going to keep doing it until I can donate it. So it's going to a good cause. You know, lastly, the one thing that I love about being part of the VCU family is that it is a family. And you know, I wasn't fortunate to play under Coach Dave, but you know, all the coaches throughout the years and all the teammates, you know, that you stay in touch with and have lifelong friends, it really is a family, and that's how, you know, it makes you feel here. So I'm, you know, very, very proud, very humbled to be part of that family, and really appreciate it.
Kodjoe became the first VCU player to win the ITA Region 2 Indoor Singles Championship when he claimed the title as a senior in the 1995-96 season. He was ranked as high as 29th nationally by the ITA in singles and 11th in doubles during his VCU career.
To introduce our next inductee, please welcome VCU tennis coach, the incomparable Paul Costin.
I want to hear what you say before I get up there.
No stories today, guys. Anyway, I'm Paul Costin. I'm the tennis coach here at VCU. I've been there for a while. Come on up. And I need to say this from my heart here. You know, I'm so honored and privileged to be able to introduce this guy. I feel like he's one of my sons. Okay, I had a few of them in the past. Into this VCU Athletic Hall of Fame. So it's your turn, my friend.
As the Associate Vice President and Director of Athletics at Virginia Commonwealth University, I am proud to induct you and welcome you into the VCU Athletics Hall of Fame.
Hello, everybody.
Hello.
Thanks, Coach. I was scared you were going to tell a couple stories. So I'm looking at this pamphlet here, page 2. So I open it up. Two things that come to mind. Number one, VCU would be pretty screwed without immigrants. So
four out of the six inductees. With the travel ban, VC would be out of luck. That's number one. And number two, apparently, when I took my picture here, was that in like in the 40s? I mean, there was no color film, no? This is so sad. And I look sad, too. I guess that was before I came here, and then when I got here, I got happy. Wow. Well, I want to first thank Ed and Glenn and the whole entire VCU family for bestowing this tremendous honor on me. I'm really humbled. Thanks, Ed. And since I am an actor, I'm going to read off the script because I'm not going to memorize all of this, especially when I get emotional. So upon hearing the news, my brother Patrick, who a lot of people in here know, he called me and said he was proud of me because he said I broke a glass ceiling. And I said, glass ceiling? What do you mean glass ceiling? He said, yeah, you're the first ever. And I asked again, I said, what do you mean first ever? And he continued by saying, yeah, the first ever 6'4", 225-pound black guy from a little town in the Black Forest region in Germany, father of two, tennis player turned Hollywood actor, who has a younger brother who starred for VCU men's basketball team in the late 90s, to be inducted into the VCU Athletics Hall of Fame. He said, you're like Neil Armstrong, man. Very funny. Well, I realized that he was joking, but I also felt that he was indeed proud of me because he, more than anybody else, knows where my journey began. So I arrived here in Richmond from Germany on what felt like the hottest day ever in the universe, in August of 1992. I was here to play tennis and learn English in that order. Stay for maybe a semester or two, you know, depending on if I liked it or not. This was my first trip to America, and I had no idea what to expect. Culture shock was immediate and brutal. Everything was different, so much bigger, faster. People on campus had no idea that I wasn't from here and spoke way too fast and without any consideration of my limited native language skills, which often landed me in some trouble or predicament because I had to guess what they were saying. I remember particularly one incident where I was very confused one time early on in the semester when a girl took me to her dorm room after I had simply asked her if we were in the same class together. I said, we in the course together? So, Coach Costin later on explained to me that I couldn't walk around campus asking girls to have intercourse. You live and learn. Of course, it got easier after a while, and I felt more comfortable every semester. Now, playing college sports and studying at VCU truly was a privilege that has afforded me more than just a university degree. My time here in Richmond has blessed me with lifelong relationships that have had a tremendous impact on my life and the man I've become. At the very center of my VCU family is Paul Costin. He recruited me unseen, there was no Facebook back then, and based on a phone conversation. And he told me later that when I stepped off the plane, he thought he had recruited a linebacker or a small forward. This man is a true legend, as you guys know. He's the winningest active tennis coach in college tennis. Give it up for that. His graduation rate is the best of any sport, and his players come from all over the world to join him here at VCU. Why? Because he cares. He cares about his players on the court, but more importantly, he cares about their achievements in the classroom, and after the time spent here in Richmond. He is a man who deeply cared about me and my aspirations beyond tennis. And to this day, I take with me the conversations we've had through the years on discipline, commitment, being prepared, and the constant affirmation of ability and confidence. I remember playing a tough match in Georgia with him by my side. I'm down in the third set and plagued by nerves and doubts. And in a late changeover, I'm losing my mind, sitting there. He's sitting next to me on the bench, chewing his 15 gums, totally relaxed. And he goes, "Ah, you're gonna kill this guy." And I asked, why you say that? I'm playing like crap. And he just shrugs and he goes, "Because you're the big B." And to this day, when I'm in doubt, that's the affirmation I choose, because I'm the big B. So thank you, Coach, for always believing in me, for your words of wisdom, and for teaching me to always keep the ball in play, because you never know what good things can happen. Now, coming here to study meant to leave my family and to venture out into the world on my own. But soon after I landed in Richmond, I found my other family. And that family here is today. That family is here today. That's Mike, Krupin, and Marty. Mike and his wife Marty were supporters of the tennis team and periodically invited the team to come over to their house, barbecue in the yard, play some tennis on the court. And the first time I went to their house, I saw people in the pool. He knows where I'm going. So being the free-spirited, innocent German boy I was, I took all my clothes off and I jumped in the pool. So that's what we do in Germany. Mike saw the shocked faces of his guests. They were pulling their kids away. And he calmly made his way over to me and proceeded to explain to me that here in America, people wear bathing suits in the swimming pool. Again, you live and learn. That was just the first occasion in which he looked out for me. For the past 25 years, this man has been a friend, a father, a voice of constant support, uncle to my children, an all-around beautiful spirit in my life. Mike, Marty, I thank you guys for always being there for me and for showing me how to love life every day and for never taking a minute for granted. I love you guys. So, before I go, I'd like to draw your attention to the most beautiful woman on the planet. When I graduated from VCU, I had no idea I would end up on a TV show called Soul Food, meeting the love of my life, the mother of my children. And I had no idea that I wouldn't want to do anything else but be with her. Babe, I want to thank you for sharing today with me, for taking my good with well, it's also good, but maybe just a little less good sometimes, just sometimes. I want to thank you for blessing me with two amazing children and a life I would have never dreamt of while visiting girls in dorm rooms here at VCU. By accident, of course. Long time ago. I love you. And I want to thank my father-in-law who's here today and his wife Joanne for being great grandparents to our kids. Pops, I always appreciate you. And again, thanks to my entire VCU family for this amazing honor. Thank you guys.
Somoano's 135 singles victories for VCU women's tennis program are 26 more than any player in school history. She's also broken the school's career leader in doubles wins. Her 48 singles wins in 1997-98 may never be broken. A two-time ITA All-American in 98 and 2001, Somoano advanced to the third round of the 1998 NCAA Singles Championship.
She was also a driving force on VCU's 2002 squad that reached the Elite Eight. A four-time first-team All-CAA selection in both singles and doubles, Somoano was named to that league's silver anniversary team in 2010.
Once again, to introduce our next inductee, VCU tennis coach Paul Costin.
I got a little touched after last speech. Okay, I'm so proud to introduce this woman, Martina Nedelkova, Somoano. Hope I said it right. She's probably one of the nearly the greatest female ever played tennis here. So, please come on up.
Martina, as the Associate Vice President and Director of Athletics at Virginia Commonwealth University, I am proud to induct you and welcome you into the VCU Athletics Hall of Fame.
Good afternoon, everybody. Congratulations to Boris and Jen and Kristine and Matthew. That is exciting to be here, inducted in the Hall of Fame. Most of all, honor and privilege. The sport of tennis has opened many doors for me, VCU being one of the most important of my life. Coming to VCU from Slovakia in 1997 was a leap of faith. I had no idea what to expect or what I was getting into. Life, education, opportunities, and tennis in my birth country was very different. I could not believe the resources, facilities, and system that exist here in the USA. Everything I needed to be successful was here at my disposal. To give you an example how I was, what I was accustomed to when I was in Slovakia, our family didn't have phone line for a long, long time. Probably until I was about 16 years old. In 1993, I was playing an ITF tournament in Colombia, South America, where I successfully made it to the finals. Because the Slovak Association didn't expect anybody to make it that far, they made tickets for the day of finals. I didn't have a way to contact my parents that I was playing finals, I was by myself, and thankfully, fortunately, I won the tournament and the Slovak press was covering it in the Slovak magazine. And somehow, mysteriously, my parents' name came on the top of the list, and pretty soon they had a phone line. So yeah, they waited about 17 years. I think they were on the waiting list for 17 years to get that. During my first years in VCU, I was learning the system and realized the privileges of studying and playing in VCU. I learned that although I was far away from my family, new family adopted me. The support of the athletic department, my teachers, academic advisors, coaches, and teammates were all part of my new life and my motivation to work hard as to never let them down. In my 5 years at VCU, I played four great seasons, traveled to amazing places, and graduated with a Bachelor of Science, graduated a Bachelor of Science in Business and Master's degree in Sports Leadership. But when it was all over, I realized what meant the most were the friends and the family here at VCU that adopted me. I want to recognize and thank two of my head coaches, Eva Bard, who is no longer with us. I miss Eva very much, and she's still in my phone book, and she always will be. She was my mentor and my friend, And just to give you an example, what Eva was like, somebody complained that foreigners are taking scholarships away from Americans. So Eva's response would be, what are you? Who are you? American Indian? Thank you to Paul. Paul made my tennis game the best it had ever been. Paul coached me my senior year after Eva retired. And I wish we would have more tennis years together. Everybody wants to finish their senior year strong. I always hoped that would happen for me, but it didn't. Toward the end of the season, I had a little setback after the shoulder surgery. I still remember it very vividly. We arrived to Stanford. We're ready to practice for the National Sweet 16. Well, I couldn't pick up my racket. Paul came to me and he said, why are you serving 5 miles an hour? Well, we played against Duke and we beat them, and I contributed with my win 6-1-6-2. However, I could not play the best of my competition the rest of the tournament. Hey, Paul, can I have a do-over? That would be so much fun. After VCU in 2014, I married to an amazing man, Carlos Somoano, and have three beautiful children, Sophia, who is 10, Gabby, who is 9, and Alexander, who is 5. I received my citizenship in May 2013, and live happy life in Cary, North Carolina. My passion for tennis didn't take me too far from it. I still teach tennis part-time at a private club. Today, I'm able to look back on my journey and recall all my great memories. What became so clear and evident that I'm sure VCU family gave me is only a fraction of what I give you back. Additionally, I want to thank the athletic director, Ed McLaughlin, Jeff Cups, former athletic director, Dr. Sander, my friend Sophia, you're right, and everybody who made this day possible. Thank you so much.
Jenn Parsons' impact on the VCU women's soccer program was similar to Delicott's influence on the men's squad. A four-time all-CAA first-team selection from 2001 to 2004, Parsons is the school's leader in points and goals. She owns four of the program's top five single-season goal totals, including a school record 16 in 2002. The 2003 CAA Player of the Year, Parsons led the Rams to their first NCAA tournament appearance in 2004. Behind Parsons, VCU also captured the 2004 CAA Championship. A three-time All-State and All-Region performer, Parsons also excelled in the classroom and was named COSIDA Academic All-American Third Team, as well as CAA Scholar Athlete in 2004 for her efforts.
To introduce our final inductee, please welcome VCU Women's Soccer Coach, Lindsay Martin.
It is my great honor to introduce our women's soccer first ever to the VCU Hall of Fame, Jenn Parsons.
Jenn, as the Associate Vice President and Director of Athletics at Virginia Commonwealth University, I am proud to induct you and welcome you into the VCU Athletics Hall of Fame.
Congratulations to all the inductees today. I'm honored to be part of such an amazing group of athletes. Thank you to VCU Athletics for this incredible honor and for celebrating us in such a wonderful way today. I'd also like to thank my coaches, Chris and Denise Brown. They're not here at VCU anymore, but they had a huge impact on my playing career, as well as my amazing teammates I played with during my 4 years. I first visited Richmond nearly 17 years ago in the fall of 2000 for a recruiting trip. I immediately fell in love with the city, the campus, and with the vision that my coaches had for the soccer program. At that point, I'd been on a number of recruiting trips, and I just knew that VCU was the place where I was meant to be. VCU is a polar opposite of where I grew up in Canada. I was from a small town on the island of Newfoundland that only has a population of 100,000 people. So, Boris, I guess that makes five of us immigrants here today. in a lot of ways, I felt like the soccer team had many similarities to my home. It was a very tight-knit family, and they showed a lot of support for one another. It also felt like joining VCU would be like being part of the underdog at that point in time, and I really liked that idea. The program was fairly new, and Chris and Denise were putting a lot of effort into building it. They convinced me that it was only going to grow and become better each season, and of course they were right, and I really wanted to be part of that. I'm glad I did. It was such a rewarding experience to be part of the growth, success, and development of a great program. Like many have mentioned today, moving thousands of miles away from home definitely has its challenges. So I'd like to take this opportunity to thank my family, particularly my parents. They always pushed me to be better and to challenge myself and to embrace opportunities to grow. For as long as I can remember, they supported my dream of moving to the U.S. to play college soccer. I was very used to them being my biggest supporters at home. They attended practically every game I ever played in. And then when I started playing for VCU, they made a trip to Richmond once a season to see a weekend of home games. And then when they weren't visiting, they spent many Friday nights and Sunday afternoons at the kitchen table watching the text version of the live stats online. I think by the time I was a senior, the technology had advanced. They even got to see a live feed of video every once in a while, which was pretty exciting for them. The memories I have from my time at VCU are incredible. I love my time here, and I'm glad I chose to become a Ram 17 years ago. I've made many lifelong friends and my teammates. Some are here today, and I'll have the opportunity to see many more of them tonight. VCU helped open doors to playing soccer at the next level after college, which was a really exciting experience. It also helped shape me as a person. I transitioned from a student athlete to spending 9 years as a high school teacher and coach, which was a really rewarding experience, but a career choice I would have never imagined unless I was for VCU. Again, I'd like to thank my coaches, teammates, and family for their continuous support. It's wonderful to see what a great job Lindsay has done with the VCU soccer program. So far, it's great to follow them and their current success. Thank you again to VCU Athletics for this exciting honor. I'm really flattered to be honored like this today.
We have one final video to take a look back at all of the highlights and accomplishments of today's honorees. Last round of applause for today's inductees. At the conclusion of this event, which is just a couple of moments away, we're going to ask all the inductees to please come back to the front of the room so we can take a group shot. We also want to remind that the athletic staff is going to be giving a tour of our beautiful basketball development center to all of our guests here today at 6:15. So at 6:15, a tour of the BDC, as we refer to it, the Basketball Development Center, which is right across the street. You don't want to miss it. It's pretty remarkable. And once again, thank you. Thank you to our inductees today, who brought so many great memories to everybody here in the VCU family. And of course, thanks to the family, friends, and supporters that joined them here on their special day. Have a great afternoon. We'll see you at the game tonight. And again, inductees in the front of the room.